my brothers and my sisters in the Lord, how are you today? Oh my gosh, don't tell anybody I'm taking a break from my other part-time job. That's right, I'm taking a break because my other job, I'm Batgirl. And I got a lot of stuff to do today, like keep those aliens away from me. So I gotta flash my discs. No, I'm just joking. You know what? Seriously, we're living in the last of the last days, and I'm excited. As a woman of strong faith, as a woman that was never a woman until recently. No, I'm just, I always knew I was a woman. But you know what? God wants us to grow up and mature in our walk with Him. And I have not been a woman of faith. You know, I've been just skipping around, having fun, doing this and lollygagging. Remember that one, when Lucifer proudly just came into the chambers where Almighty God was standing with his angels? And God's like, where were you? And Satan was like, oh, I was down in the earth roaming to and fro. You know how I am, God. I do whatever I want. And I know you didn't invite me here with your angels, but you know me, I'm rude. And I'm full of pride. And I used to be the most elegant, luminous, awesomest, glorious. You know, that's his... Lucifer used to be the most beautiful angels of all angels. I know. And he blew it by that one word that starts with a P, and it rises inside of all kinds of people. Pride. And what does the Bible say about pride? Pride goes before a fall. So when you just think about that, first he's this angel of light that God blessed, and then he gets all full of pride and ego, and I'm going to be like the Most High God. And I, you know, isn't that what we do? Isn't that what we all do? We work because we need that job. And we're on the city bus. Okay? Sorry I'm late, boss. It wasn't me. It's, you know, the transit system. I would have been here like 2 minutes ago if it weren't for that red light. I told the bus driver I could walk across the street and get to work on time, but he said he couldn't do that. You know, we see our bosses drive up in these expensive cars, owning these great big houses on the beach, and, you know, we're living on mama's couch, taking a bus. You know, then one day, don't you see your boss walk in with that Armani suit? And here we are wearing jeans and a polo shirt because, you know, we work for the boss. And then one day we're like, you know what? I'm tired of making minimum wage. I want to be the boss. You know what I mean? That's what happened when Lucifer, I know, he's a liar. He wanders anywhere he wants. Well, you know what? This isn't about the devil. This is about how the devil thinks he's running the show. When he's not! He clearly is not. But he is given a short time. And we're living in those times right now. That's why I hope this video reaches somebody because we're not going to fake the funk over here. We are going to praise the Lord. We are going to lift up his name. We are going to thank God for Jesus. We are going to praise his holy name because he is so worthy to be praised. We are going to take dominion back from the enemy. We are going to reclaim territory that the devil thinks he owns. We are going to praise the Lord all day, all night, starting in the morning. We're going to do it in the afternoon. We're going to do it at night. We're going to praise the Lord. I don't know who out there is just like me. You wake up, you praise the Lord. You thank God that we're here another day. The devil is a liar. He's trying to dismember the church. He's trying to pull us apart in different directions. He's trying to make us feel miserable, like we're all alone. I don't know about you, but I was grinding my teeth the other night. I was grinding my teeth. It must have been this dream I was having. I was just, oh my gosh. My days of just, oh. Don't you ever just feel like, you know, the enemy, you're just not going to let him mess with you again. You just grit your teeth so bad because, you know, he chases you during the day. And then you try to get a decent night's sleep. And then he's in your dreams or your nightmares. And then you like wake up, you know, after hearing a popping noise. You know, you hear a popping noise and you're like, was that in the dream? Was it just in my head? Did somebody throw a rock at my bedroom window? Like, what was that? You know what I mean? I know what that is. I know what that's like. When you just don't feel his presence. When you feel like, you know what, I'm surrounded by all sides here. And I don't see how, I mean, you know, when Jesus said, Jesus is God's son, and I don't want to get into it or fight, you know, but we all know what, we're all on the same page. Jesus was God in the flesh. And he made himself even conform to the cross. I mean, when you look at how Jesus hung on the cross, both of his arms were outstretched. You know, we have two legs as human beings. What did they do to Jesus? This is spiritual. They took both of his feet like that. One nail went through both of his feet after they brought both of his feet, one behind the other, and they drove the nail through one of his, to pierce both of his feet. You know, the reason why I mention that is because I just learned in a Bible study class that Jesus has a way of conforming himself to fit us and our circumstances and what we're going through. You know what I mean? And even when Jesus was getting ready to do what his Father sent him to do, which was just a forgiveness of everybody's sins. You know, a lot of people, they don't understand. They don't understand the spiritual battle. They don't understand the spiritual warfare. They don't understand it hasn't stopped. We believers have been under attack for over 2,000 years. It's been passed down generation to generation to generation to generation to generation. We are that generation. If you know you're supposed to open up your mouth and tell somebody that Jesus loves them and to ask them, do you know Jesus is your Lord and Savior? We're not supposed to be embarrassed or uncomfortable right now. I'm not. But I do have to tone myself down and I have to be more professional about this. And I'm clearly not. I'm not professional about doing God's business. You know? I see somebody and then I hear a tug or feel a tug on my heart. It could be a man, you know, a homeless man. And God says, go ask him if he knows the Lord. And I'm like, okay, I'm doing it. And I walk up to him and sit next to the guy. I've done this a dozen times. I'm like, excuse me, you know, real softly, you know, you don't know what kind of mental issues people have. I don't want them to like wake up from nodding and just start beating me up. You gotta be gentle. You know, Jesus has a spirit of gentleness. Donna doesn't! I know! I'm so frantic. I'm like, oh my gosh! Ugh, I'm working on it. I really am. But you know what? I can't do anything without the Lord. And just like when Jesus was getting ready to hang on the cross, because he knew he was going to be rejected, made fun of, spit at, called names, you know, rejected as the Son of God. He knew the crowds were going to love him one day because he was feeding them. Oh, everybody loves Jesus when the blessings are coming in. Oh, when you got a job and there's a roof over your head and, you know, you and your mama are getting along and everybody loves you in the family because you got some cookies and they want a cookie, so everybody's so nice to mama. But once them cookies are gone, nobody wants to hug you or kiss you. It's like, where'd you guys go? You don't have any more blessings. Your cookies ran out. Don't call us for nothing. You know, I love God because he's not like that. He's not like that. You know? He's not like, well, I'm going to be nice to you because you were nice to me. In spite of us, he still loves us. That's awesome! That's awesome! You know what I mean? We got to tell people. I mean, it's not just tell somebody. It's not just tell a friend. It's tell an enemy. It's remind somebody that, you know what? I love you. Jesus loves you. There's a God. There's a Jesus. We have a creator. We have a Lord and a Savior. We also have a black, evil, dark spirit that just roams around this earth seeking to whom he can devour, kill, destroy, use, lie to, abuse, mislead, deceive, scare. The enemy will do everything he can in his dark bag of tricks. He's like, oh, look what I got in this pocket. I mean, there's nothing in these pockets. Just, you know, I'm just letting you know, I'm not an evil witch over here. I'm just saying, the devil knows, all right? The devil knows. He'll grab things out of the bag. If you're in debt, he'll be like, oh, well, look what I got here. You don't want to do sins for me? Well, let's see. How much money do you owe? Oh, and percentage? Yeah. Well, apparently, Mr. Smith, if you don't rob those accounts that you have been given, you've got 6 months or you lose your job. I know the company's going through reorganizational problems. Well, they're not problems for me, but they could be problems for you, Mr. Smith. What is it gonna be? Is it gonna be your paycheck? What about your house? What about those kids that go to private school? What about that nice expensive car you just bought the missus? You're not gonna be able to make payments, Mr. Smith. I own you. Don't you forget it. Oh, you're laughing, Mrs. Jenkins. What do we have in here? Oh my gosh, if you don't do something evil at your job, you're not gonna have money and you won't be able to text all your friends. I know, Miss Jenkins. Everything you do is from your phone. It's from your phone. You know, that thing you look at every day. All your pictures and Facebook and Instagram and oh my gosh, you're gonna lose friends. You're not gonna be popular. You're not gonna get those text messages to meet at Starbizox for cafe lappuccinos and muffins. Oh, Miss Jenkins, you better do something for me today. I own you. Here we have Donna. Well, Donna, let's see. Oh, how can I trick Donna? You mean she gave those addictions to the Lord? You mean she doesn't pick up? You mean she's not using? She hasn't. What? Are you serious? Are we talking about the same Donna here? Oh my gosh, there's nothing in there. That's because the devil is a liar. He thinks he has all of us in his web, and he doesn't. If you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you're free. You're free. And whom the Lord sets free is free indeed. You're free. You're free. I said you're free. Free. You're free. Free. We are sinners, but we're free. We're free. I said we're free. Free. We're free. Everlasting is free indeed. It's free indeed. If you're in need, just go to the Lord right now. He'll show you how and bow. Just go to the Lord right now. He'll show you how. If you're stuck, don't be in the muck. You're not really stuck. You're free. You're free. You're free. You're free. If you're watching me, you're free. If you're laughing, you're free. If you're gonna leave me a comment, then you're free. You're free. When Jesus saved us and said, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. If you don't feel empowered, you need to know where the empowering power comes from. It comes from Jesus. If you feel stuck, like you're in a rut, it's not going to be found on Facebook, Tumblr, tweets, Twitter, Google, Yahoo, Juno, Hotmails. I don't even know what else is out there. There's so many things coming out there. About a week ago, I got a message from somebody from you through YouTube, and they were like, hey, Donna, if you start out with the alphabet A to Z and start with A being 6, so B would be 12, and then 6 times 3 is 24, so then, oh my gosh, okay, every letter, A, B, C, so what you're doing is, oh my gosh, I got the calculator, but I'm not going to do that for the sake of time, and I haven't done it yet. But if you take the alphabet and you put the number six next to the alphabet letter, and so my brain, I'm not good with like math, so you know, it's a lot of numbers and stuff to remember. Like if I said, okay, if we're gonna use 6 for the alphabet, then what's Y, Mr. Smarty Pants? There's gonna be people out there that go, oh, that's this letter in the alphabet and times 6. Well, Donna, that's this. Well, see, you're a genius because I don't know what that number is. And some of you are gonna put the answer in your comments thing. Because when I log off, I gotta like log off and teach homeschool. But I was like, somebody needs to hear that Jesus loves them. I know, I should have left a few minutes ago. But anyways, oh my gosh. Supposedly, if you do what I just told you, 6, 12, 24, wait, 6, 12, okay, anyways. When you write the word computer, C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R, on a paper, and then you do your do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, 6 letters, whatever, and then you add up all the numbers, supposedly, 666, supposedly. And supposedly that is computer. Okay, well, on BP Earth Watch, he had a video 666 with a very interesting message. And I am going to read a quick Bible verse and then I gotta go. This is not saying that anybody is being self-righteous. This is letting everybody, believers of the faith, just to let you know we're living in the last days. Jesus said, don't be deceived. Okay? I'm a sinner saved by grace. I'm supposed to grow and mature in the Lord. I'm working on it. I'm not there yet. I said I'm working on it. Jeepers. Don't expect me to be like, you know, like these women that are all serious and take life seriously. Today could be my last day. I want to enjoy it. Okay, seest thou a man wise in his own conceit? There is more hope of a fool than a him. And that's in Proverbs 26, verse 12. But he that glories, let him glory in the Lord. For not he that commands himself is approved, but whom the Lord commendeth. That's found in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 17. This is my last Bible verse. This is found in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 25. He that is of a proud heart stirs up strife, but he that puts his trust in the Lord shall be made fat. He that trusts in his own heart is a fool, but whoso walketh wisely, he shall be delivered. That's for me. Except I don't want to be fat, okay? I don't want to be fat, okay? I'm just saying. Whoever wants my meat and Fritos and all the fat stuff off of my plate, you can have it. I don't want it. I don't want to be fat. Okay, oh my, there's nothing wrong with being fat. It's just, it's, you know, I'm not even going to go there. Forget it. Nobody would understand. Okay. Surely, this is my last Bible verse. I love God. I love these verses. This is where we meditate and chew on. See, man can't live on bread alone. We have to live by God's words. We do. And I think the end of my videos are the best part of the video, because this is where I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta go, and I can't leave my subscribers feeling like they didn't get their spiritual food. And that's why I saved the best for last. So open up your mouths. You're getting another spoonful. I'm gonna force feed you guys. Oh my gosh. Okay, in Galatians chapter 6, verse 3. See, we got a lot of self-righteous, pompous, self-righteous people running around in this world, okay? And I don't know who they are, but God knows who they are. I know. So this is my last Bible verse, and then I got a G-O. I know! Okay. Here we are in Galatians chapter 6, verse 3. For if a man thinks himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. I don't want anybody to deceive as themselves, and I don't want to deceiveth myselfeth, because without the Lord, I am nothing, and I already know this. That's why I love doing videos, because I do it for the Lord. I'm not good at doing videos. I don't use a teleprompter. These are just original videos. In all my sarcastic, witty senses of humor, pretending that, you know, the devil wants to own your soul by using your finances and by, you know, trying to, you know, get your mind to think about, oh, maybe I could rob Bank of America. Oh, yeah. Grandma is like in a convalescent home now, but she left her checkbook in a drawer. Maybe I can just, you know, fill out an amount and go visit grandma in the home and have her sign it. Because I hear they have her on different meds now. You don't know the evil things that people are thinking. I know! Who would do such a thing? But they're doing it. I'm telling you, God help these younger kids. I'm telling you, they're doing it. And don't they know when they get caught, they're going to go to the... Yeah, anyways, we got to pray for these non-believers and these people that are desperate doing bad things. People are desperate and they're doing bad things. I love you and I totally have to go. I'm trying to mature in the Lord. Please leave a comment. I love you. I don't get mad. I love... What's that word again? Constructive criticism. You can criticize me all you want if it's out of love. And if you feel like it's going to make me a better speaker and make me more confident. Oh my gosh, they're calling me. I gotta go. I'll be there right away. Hold on, I'm signing off. I gotta go to my other job and fly away back into the dark, dark cave. Oh my gosh. I'm just joking. Hey, you know what? I love being funny. Jesus loves you, and that's for reals. That's serious, okay? We're living in a spiritual world. We got the good and the bad, and I'm in the middle. I want to do good, and I'm going to keep doing good, and I'm going to keep my eyes focused on the Lord. And for all you big kids out there, Remember Batman? Na 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 na. Batman! I gotta go. I love you. Oh, because I'm gonna be around my kids. Romper room. Oh, Jesus, help me.